Let's go through, and what we're going to do is we're going to go through and do our example that we did earlier, which is 5-year term bond, $1 million, and we'll go through doing both of these, discounted premium. So we'll do 8% stated, issued at 10, 8% stated, issued at 6, and then we'll go through and do the effective interest table. Now, my numbers aren't going to be exact because I kind of want to make it a little bit easier for me to get through the calculations, but you'll see how it works. So we're going to set up our amortization table, which has the face plus or minus, and we're going to have plus or minus our premium or discount that equals your carrying value times the effective interest rate. Now, the effective interest rate, that is the rate that you effectively want to yield. That is the effective interest rate. That equals your interest expense or interest income, because one guy's expense is another guy's income. So we're looking at one guy's expense is another person's income. That's kind of the difference between the two, to understand the difference between them. So we're trying to see interest expense, interest income, so that way we can understand it for the formula. So that's interest expense, interest income, minus the cash payment. So minus cash payment. Now, with cash payment, this is an important concept, because the cash payment is going to be what? It is going to be, and how did we calculate the cash? Remember, the cash is which rate, the effective or the stated? The stated rate, exactly, very good. So it's going to be your face, $1 million, times stated rate, times time. That is going to be the cash payment. The difference between those equals what? Amortization of your discount or premium. Okay, so that's how we're going through. That is our basic formula. Okay, so let's do this again. We start out face, so that would be the $1 million. Plus or minus your discount or premium of 100 equals 980. I'm sorry, minus 100 is 900. That's our carrying value. Times the effective rate. Now, I wanted to earn in a discount 10% equals 90. That's your interest expense. My expense is your income, expense income. Minus cash payment. Now, how much cash? $1 million times 8% times time is 12/12. If they're paying semi-annually, times 6/12. So $1 million and 8% is 80,000. Boom. Equals amortization is 10. So when we go through that discount, and let's kind of go through my steps again that I erased, but we want to learn them anyway, so let's try it. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, credit, bonds payable for $1 million. Accrued interest payable, none. Cash, 900. BIC, zero. Difference, discount of 100. All right. So notice, in most questions, they don't have this, they don't have this. Credit, bonds payable, debit, cash. Difference is discount or premium. What's the carrying value? 900. Okay? So, we have face of $1 million, discount of 100, carrying value 900. What is it? It is stated rate, 8%, effective, and a discount. In this case, we want to earn 10. Now, setting that up, we come back here. We go $1 million plus or minus, in this case, minus the discount is 900. At 10% is 90, minus 80 is 10. Now, this face doesn't change, right? It's $1 million. But this has to go $1 million minus, this has to go to zero, because this has to get bigger to $1 million. So in a discount, notice, it starts small and gets bigger, bigger, bigger. So you take the 10 and you go, okay, that's 90. $1 million minus 90 equals 900 plus 10 is 910. 910 at 10% is 91 minus 80 is 11. This goes up, 921 at 10% is 92.1 minus 80 equals 12. What do you need to know? Very important for theoretical type questions. In a discount, it starts small and it gets bigger, bigger, bigger. If you're multiplying it times an effective rate, as the carrying value gets bigger, your interest expense gets bigger. 80 versus 90, 80 versus 91, 80 versus 95, 80 versus 99. What's happening to the difference every year? It also gets bigger. So in a discount, this goes up, interest expense, and amortization. Okay, because it starts small at 900 and ends up at $1 million. So the concept here is every year, and this is your journal entry, comes right out of here. So let me clean this up. First journal entry is you credited bonds payable for $1 million, debited cash for $900, debited discount for $100. So what do we do every year? Boom, journal entry comes right out of here. What are we gonna do? We are going to credit out your discount, and we're amortizing the discount right here of 10 bucks, and we're gonna have interest expense and some cash. Now, how much cash are we paying every year? Cash, 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 and I'll put that, should be underneath it, 80. Notice the cash doesn't change. They're gonna give you these tables blank, you have to fill them out. So if they give you cash once, you got cash for the next three questions. Okay, so what is, that was a good look, wasn't it? So, how much is cash? 80 bucks. What's your plug? Interest expense, 90. So notice your journal entry comes right out of here. So now what happens? Your discount was 100, it went down by 10. So how much is the carrying value of your discount? Discount is down to 90. What is the carrying value of the bonds? 910, and so on. The next year, what's your journal entry? Same 80, but this goes to 11, 91. This is 80, 12, 92, and so on. So after 5 years, what happens? This goes to zero. Then at the end, I've amortized out the discount, which did what? The discount made my interest expense more than the cash. This was 8%. This is more like 9, 9 1/4, and so on. And that's why when you do the real calculation, the real amount should have been 924, not 900. That's why the numbers don't work exactly. But I want you to learn the concepts, because in most questions, they'll give you the numbers to use. You just have to understand the flow of the formula. That's what's happening in a discount. So remember, every year, this is getting bigger. So interest expense goes up, boom, and this goes up. Let's do the same question in a premium. So let's come back over here and start out. What are we doing? Credit bonds payable for $1 million. None of that. We're charging $1,000,001. That gives us a premium for $100. What's my carrying value? Boom, $1,000,001. What's it have to go down to? $1 million. What do I have to do? Amortize out the premium. So you can see, just based on this journal entry, instead of a discount, the word's gonna be up here, premium, which means this number's gotta be smaller than this. That's gonna make my interest expense less. Why? Because I want you to earn less than what I'm paying you. Okay, so let's come over here and set this chart up again. So here we'll do, that's a discount, let's do a premium. Starting here at $1 million plus 100 is $1,000,001. How does it have to go? It has to go down, down, down to $1 million, get smaller, smaller, smaller. Times, now remember, this is 6%, because we were issuing it at a premium, which means I'm gonna pay you still 8%, but I only want you to earn 6%. That equals, let's just say, about 66 minus 80 equals 14. Now, taking away 14 gives me 1086 at 6% equals, I don't know, let's just make up 64 minus 80 equals 16. Minus 16 equals 1070 at 6%, and so on. Notice every year in a premium, it starts big and gets smaller. So as this goes down times the interest, this goes down. Now watch, 80, 66, 80, 64, 80, 60, 80, 52. What happens to the difference every year? It still gets what? Bigger. So in both cases, amortization gets bigger each year. In a discount, it starts small and gets bigger, interest expense goes up. In a premium, interest expense goes down. So let's look at this. What's your journal entry? Well, we're gonna credit cash of 80, that's easy. We started over here with this journal entry of premium, so we've gotta debit out the premium, and in the first case, we're gonna debit it out for 14. What's your plug? Interest expense, which is 66. The next year, whoosh, this is still 80, but instead of 14, it's 16, difference 64. Next year, next year, next. So, you know, like your home mortgage, right? Your home mortgage starts high and it goes down eventually to zero. So you could go home and set this up for, if you have a 30-year loan times 12, 360 months, you could do an amortization schedule for your home by hand. That's good practice. Yeah, yeah, they'll have 360 different loans. There's programs that do that for you. But notice here, we've got a five-year bond, term bond, boom, 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 maybe a serial bond, matures twice a year, and so on. But that's what I want you to see the difference between discount amortization. Look at the discount amortization underneath the journal entries. Note, didn't mean to wake you. Note, when amortizing a discount, interest expense increases each year, and the amortization of the discount increases each year. So interest expense increases and your discount amortization. Look over here. Interest expense increases each year and amortization increases each year. Notice the premium. Note, when amortizing a premium, interest expense decreases each year. However, right, this decreases, amortization of the premium increases each year. So those are asked in theoretical type questions. It's really important that you understand that. Okay, in a minute, we're going to talk about a few other issues that go hand in hand with bonds.